The world's biggest passenger airliner, the superjumbo Airbus A380, was rolled out for the first time in France today.
Double-decker of the air, Airbus unveils its behemoth. More than 500 seats, over a million pounds.
The Airbus A380 superjumbo is the world's biggest commercial passenger aircraft, seating on average 555 passengers in three different classes. At its densest, the double-decker four-engined aircraft has a maximum certified capacity of 853 in an all-economy configuration. Interestingly, Airbus was not satisfied with this capacity and actually drew up plans for an A380 stretch. This aircraft would be theoretically capable of carrying over 1,000 passengers. So in today's video, let's explore what could have been. So, after the A380 was released to the market in 2000, Airbus proposed an A380-200 stretch that would bump the number of seats from 555 to 656 in a three-class layout. But then, in 2007, Airbus proposed a further extension of the A380-800. Dubbed the -900, this variant would include 650 seats in a three-class format, but up to 900 in an all-economy configuration. Believe it or not, several airlines reacted with expressions of interest. Emirates, who of course would go on to operate the largest A380 fleet in the world, was one such airline.
It's a hugely popular aeroplane. I've said this many times. Our client base grows all the time. People go out of their way to fly on it.
But there was also Virgin Atlantic, Cathay Pacific, Air France, KLM, Lufthansa, and India's now-defunct Kingfisher Airlines. Interestingly, some of these airlines would go on to operate the A380-800, while some would stay clear of the superjumbo. Virgin Atlantic, Cathay Pacific, KLM are all carriers that never ended up flying the aircraft. Kingfisher did place an order for the superjumbo, but the airline would cease operations before being able to take delivery of the jet. Several air leasing companies also indicated that they would consider purchasing such an aircraft. Airbus unfortunately had to park these proposed orders until they could deliver on the original A380-800 variant. With the launch of the NEO program for the A320, Airbus returned to plans for the Airbus A380 stretch. The European plane maker proposed that once they had developed an A380-NEO and improved the fuel efficiency of the aircraft, they would then roll out the A380-900. Rumours have it that Airbus was also considering an A380-1000 stretch that would have had 200 more seats than the A380-800. This would have capacity for just over 1,000 passengers. Who knows if an airline would have gone for this massive aircraft, even just for the prestigious award of having the highest capacity aircraft in the world. But as fate would have it, the production of the A380 was slowly wound down and then shut down. This would effectively kill any plans for an even larger A380. So what killed the development of this aircraft variant? Well, simply put, the lack of demand for a stretch was the primary reason Airbus never offered the A380-900. Working within a free market, Airbus would naturally need to have orders and down payments in order to make the program feasible. Of course, the plane maker couldn't even sustain the regular A380 program. With this being the case, they had to ask themselves if there were any hopes of being profitable with an even bigger version. Some have suggested that Airbus should have offered the A380-900 from the get-go rather than the smaller A380-800. There are actually a handful of markets where the A380 stretch could have been useful. One of these might have been China. With such a huge population and plans to build hundreds of airports in the coming years, a large capacity aircraft like the A380 stretch would have done wonders. Routes like Beijing to Shanghai that are incredibly dense could have benefited from such a massive aircraft. Secondly, India might have been an excellent location for the aircraft. Like China, their population and demand for air travel could have justified such a large plane. Additionally, India has one of the most cutthroat airfare markets and could have benefited from the incredibly low fuel burn per seat on the A380 stretch. Holidaymakers on popular routes such as Seoul's Gimpo Airport to Jeju, an island off of the southern coast of the Korean peninsula, could have deployed the A380 stretch to good effect. In case you didn't know, this city pair is the most heavily trafficked route in the world and saw over 16 million passengers in 2022. And lastly, airlines that provide transport for the Muslim pilgrimage to Mecca would have most definitely considered the A380 stretch. Airlines like Malaysia Airlines, Lion Air, and others in principally Muslim countries would have opted for the all-economy configuration to transport as many of the faithful as possible. And these passengers would have been satisfied with this dense configuration too, as the journey to Mecca is supposed to be an arduous test of your faith. With around half the world's A380 fleet now back in service following the pandemic, could a stretched A380 be back on the cards? Unfortunately, there's essentially zero chance that Airbus would revive the A380 program. Indeed, it was a loss-making endeavor with the regular A380-800 variant anyway. The most feasible customer would of course be Emirates, which operates the world's largest A380 fleet by a considerable distance. The carrier's CEO, Sir Tim Clark, told CNN in 2022 that the airline would be interested in another mega Airbus aircraft. As recent as June 2023, Clark echoed this sentiment at the Paris Air Forum, but is more interested in a re-engined, more efficient A380neo than a stretch. Whatever the case may be, demand would have to be quite significant for Airbus to even consider such an undertaking at this point. That's because much of the A380's assembly space in Toulouse has now been converted to being an A320neo family final assembly line. Sadly, it really does look as if the age of new jumbo jets is effectively over. Interestingly, Russia was working on its own 1,000-seater jumbo jet before the A380 ever took to the skies. However, this proposed Sukhoi KR-860 never made it past the drawing board. So what do you think? Do you think a larger A380 variant would have done better with sales? Or would it have been worse off? Let us know what you think and why by leaving a comment down below. Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.